What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 14. This one, finally head down to Patetonga Speedway, catch up with Michael Pickens and Brock Maskovich, and they chucked me behind the wheel of their sprint car and midget. And man, it's one hell of a wild ride driving those things. So it was a lot of fun and something I've wanted to do for a long time. Can't wait to get them out in the off season and jump behind the wheel of this thing and see how they go in a drift car on the track. So yeah, check that out. Then we'll head over, catch up with Cole. He had a bit of an engine problem at round four, so he's been working pretty hard the last few weeks trying to get that all fixed. He had to get a whole new block, machine everything, reassemble. Obviously needs to go back on the dyno, and he's had a couple of little issues on the way. So yeah, we'll see how he's going. Hopefully it's all going smoothly now, and he can get that car all done and dusted, ready to go for this weekend at Manfield. So yeah, check it out. Let us know what you think. And we'll see you guys this weekend, D1NZ round 5 for the Grand Final at Manfield. See you there. What's up, guys? We are here at Patetonga Speedway Track. Just checking it out. Just been prepped, ready to go for today. We'll be having to go in one of Brock Maskovich's midgets, and then Michael Pickens' sprint car. So should be a bit of fun. Track's looking good. Just laid down some water, so a few laps should have that pretty tacky. So go have a look at the cars.
Right, you're seeing my ugly face again.
Oh, I love this show! It's my favourite.
We are here.
Oh, I love him.
And my mate, Lim.
Oh, not her, bud. Oh, no, she's such a mole.
CDM, Taronga. As you all know, the last round we cracked the block. So we've been pretty hard out trying to get two blocks back together. But yeah, I'll show you what's going on. Anyway, we are now at the moment. So we're in his engine building room. He's the man and trying to get this thing sorted. But we're having a serious issue. I've never had it before, but we've got the 3.2 crank. Now if you rotate it the normal clockwise way, you can see the rod comes up. Yep, goes back down. Donk! It's hitting. Oh, never had this. Normally the 3.2 has full clearance. There you go, it comes through. If we look down in there, see the rod? So pretty gutted about that. I'm gonna have to go through and now clearance this block so we can try and get some room for these rods to come up and in. But not what you need at all. Alright, so I think I've done it. As you can see, I've had to notch that out. They've gone down about that far on all of them. Now, I've never had this problem before, but as you can see, I've done the other side just to be sure. Now, I'm going to be super peeved if I haven't done it enough, but it only just was catching, so fingers crossed. As you can see, like, there's my old two blocks, neither of them have been done. No old reason. Maybe this one's got more meat to it, hopefully, fingers crossed. So fingers crossed we can get it sussed out and stuff will be all good. We can assemble it tomorrow and fingers crossed go it in the car. So we are Easter Friday, rolling CDM, Lynn, the man, is here. Help us try build this motor. Hopefully I got the grinding done and the clearance is sweet. But yeah, fingers crossed, it all goes well today. Here we are. Back together. Got the exhaust to go on. You know, I want a few old 30 blocks. These here are all knackered. Here are the pistons that are in it. The colour of the oil. Mint. We've got two knackered blocks, so I've been able to fit all the engine mounts, pretty much strip the other block, just fit everything back over. But yeah, I've just finished putting the inlet on. Now we've got the exhaust to go, whole set turbo. Now I've got to go clean this dry sump pump because it is filthy. All the lines, every line out of that car has to be taken out. Cleaned out. What we normally have on the block where we do our exhaust brackets, these here end up hitting, so we have to now trim out all here. But you can see all my big ported polished well, they're not polished now, but they were polished, and look at the water that was coming out of that one. The hottest hip hop and brown R&B is on 96.6. So now, third day in the weekend, Sunday, back down here. It's a cracker day outside. Should be out with my old man fishing, but anyway, just got this back in the hole. So pretty stoked about that. This sucker back in. Still got lots to do. I've got to clean all the dry sump lines, all the oil filter, all the oil cooler. Just everything's choked up that white iced coffee. So yeah, it's me for the rest of the day. Clean it up and hopefully later today I can start it and yeah, make sure we've got a runner again. Yeah, beauty. Another roadie down to the necky. Got the car on the back. Sun is out. And we are doing another mission. Yesterday, good day. Got the car all up and running. Still got a bit of a misfire, not sure what it is. I had to inject the wire around the wrong way, so thought that might have been it, but still not quite running right. So as we are, lucky Rossi is working on this lovely Monday. We're on our way down to the Naki, hope to go for a quick tune-up, make sure everything's good to go before the final round. We can park this thing up for a couple of days, get some big mahi in, and send it for the last round. Hopefully we don't have this sort of carry-on. It's real splendid weather. But if you give the old ute a bit of a whoop, got the trailer on the back. Goes for the old SMD. Alright, so here we are back in the main shed. Main man over there. We're at Ross's Top Tune. Coming here just for a quick dyno, you know, make sure it's sweet, good to go. Oh nah. So we're pulling that back off because we're checking the clearances, the little shims with the 26 head. They have little shims in there. One of the valves is not holding compression. It's a number 4 at the moment. We've got no compression in there, so it's running like a dog. So fingers crossed. We're adjusting all these, as you can see. I'll bring it down in there. These are all the shims that are on the top there. The buckets, they sit on top, and then they have little shims underneath. So we'll show you what Ross is doing over here. See, so these here are the buckets, the little shims that go under them. So now he is adjusting them, so hopefully the valve will close and we'll get compression and we can get it tuned in and be back out there. Who would have thought? I didn't know this needed to be done. But anyway, luckily we've got the main man here. It's a cute smile there, Rossi. Yeah. As you can see, here are the buckets, shims. See, they're all different sizes. Now he's got a whole heap more new ones. Because Ross likes his RB motors, so he's got parts for Africa. It's perfect. Well, this is a video I don't really like to take. As you can see, I'm still down here, and we've had a yeah, that was a big beep. And you can see, there's no head on there. Had a little bit of a meltdown. I'm gonna put the cam back in. Bit of a brain fart, and bent two valves. Now, lucky for me, I've got custom valves, so they're real easy to get. No worries. Anyway, should be parked up, tucked away. Come on, buddy. It's okay. These things happen. Bugger. Blinking bugger.
The title fight is here. Join us at Manfield Raceway for the Galore Parks D1NZ Championship Grand Final. 5 drivers line up for their shot at the final podium of the season. For the first time ever, it's Nissan versus Ford. Will Darren Kelly score another victory for the RBs, or will Fanger Dan bring the V8 heat with Adam Davies right behind in his 13B rotary? Plus, it's the final round of the TurboSmart Pro Sport Restricted Class, with Michael Thorley battling Taylor James and Kurt Blackie for the 2019 title. Champions will be crowned. Mimico Industrial Machinery presents Round 5, the Grand Final, Manfield Circuit, Chris Amon, April 26th and 27th, 2019. Tickets at the gate or book online at d1nz.com. I still want the act, not the ghost.
Done trying to make y'all comfortable. That's right. For the record, you ain't trying to grow, then it's done for you. That's right. For the record, lab on me going
home. She's wearing straps. Her and Kylie, we're switched at birth. Why are we watching this? Isn't there a test on the other channel?
And the home side have stolen it. Well, here's trouble for the Wallabies.